witch who dwelt in Amesbury. With brilliant eye and salty tongue, she worked her sorcery. And as unto the judge's court, the sheriff brought her hither, the lilacs drooped as she passed by, and then were seen to wither. A witch was she, though trig and neat, with comely head held high. It did not seem that one as she with Satan so would vie. And when in court the afflicted ones proclaimed her evil ways, she laughed aloud and boldly then met Cotton Mather's gaze. Who hath bewitched these maids, he asked, and strong was her reply. If they be dealing in black arts, you know as well as I. And now the stricken ones made moan as she approached near. They saw her shape upon the beam, so none could doubt 'twas there. The neighbors round swore to the truth of her satanic powers, that she could fly o'er land and stream and come dry shod through showers. At night 'twas said she had appeared, a cat of fearsome mien. Avoid she, devil, they had cried, to keep their spirits clean. The spectral evidence was weighed, then stern the parson spoke. Thou shalt not suffer a witch to live, 'tis written in the book. Susanna Martin, so accused, spake with flaming eyes, I scorn these things, for they are naught but filthy gossip's lies. Now those bewitched, they cried her out, their voices loud did ring. They saw a bird above her head, an evil yellow thing. And so Susanna Martin died beneath the summer sky. And still in scorn she faced the rope, her comely head held high.